Hello, this is the second video of the beginner's videos on functional safety. This video gives you a summary of the six most important points of functional safety management according to ISO 26262. My name is Erwin Petri, I'm functional safety expert for the automotive area at Kugler Maag. I hope you can profit from listening to this video. It's a common belief that functional safety is just one of many issues that the project manager must coordinate when developing electronics for vehicles. In other words, those who can do project management can also do functional safety management. Be careful. Experience shows that this belief leads to massive problems towards the end of the project. Why? Because the safety of the product cannot be proven. This is only possible if the organization has made arrangements and a number of things are considered over the development period. There's no functional safety if you don't manage functional safety. Let's have a look into ISO 26262. Part 2 is especially dedicated to the management aspect of the whole safety lifecycle. Part 2 in particular says how to manage the topic of functional safety. You'll find three clauses with requirements in Part 2. The first of these relates to the development organization. The second is related to each development project, and the third relates to the post-development phase. In a number of other clauses of ISO 26262, there are further requirements that are closely related to managing functional safety. For example, in the corresponding parts of ISO 26262, there are certain life cycles for hardware and software development. And, for instance, it's required that certain coding guidelines must be defined and applied. In the following minutes, I will explain the most important points and you will take the key lessons with you to avoid problems in time. Let's start with point number one. For functional safety in automotive, a so-called safety life cycle has been defined, which you see here. Related to that, life cycle management is addressed in three areas. We see that there is overall safety management, project-specific safety management, and post-release management. Let me slightly reformulate this and keep this in mind as a first key lesson. Management of functional safety needs to be addressed on an organizational level, on a per-project level, and for the time after release for production. Let's turn to our second point. This point comes from overall safety management, which we consider now. Overall safety management requires that your company must have a defined and applied procedure for electronics development. For example, this includes procedures to define a company's specific lifecycle, to define which tools to use, how to organize configuration management, and which kinds of safety analysis to perform. A quality assurance system must be set up. This aspect is strongly supported by the Automotive SPICE standard as well. Automotive SPICE supports the implementation of ISO 26262. Let me refer to our Automotive SPICE tutorials for more information. Then, it's expected that you are qualified for the work assigned to you. This means that there must be active competence management in your organization. Functional safety requires that you have a process in place to ensure that safety anomalies are identified, communicated, and resolved. Overall, the term people use for this is a culture of safety, which every company should have. This also includes, for example, that resources that are required for functional safety are actually made available by management. Let me summarize the above points as a second key lesson. An organization that develops electronic products for cars must have a safety culture and processes for functional safety. We come to point number three. The question regarding what functional safety management includes at the project level. The various activities must be carried out by people. This requires roles to be defined and people to be assigned. In particular, it must be clear who is responsible for the functional safety of the product. An impact analysis shows what needs to be done in the course of product development. Because in the rarest of cases, a company starts a development from scratch. There is usually a previous version of the product. The result of the impact analysis is used to tailor the lifecycle and to plan the necessary safety activities. Logically, functional safety management also includes continual monitoring of progress against the plan and, if necessary, revising the plan. All of these are the tasks of a so-called safety manager. We can summarize this as key lesson number three. Each safety-related electronics project has a safety manager responsible for that area and tailored safety planning. The next point is about documenting safety evidence. One of the key work products we have to develop is a sound argumentation for the product being safe. This is called the safety case. It includes a suitable strategy to achieve safety. It includes evidence that this strategy was actually followed, and it includes pieces of evidence the work products produced during development. Lesson number four, a key output of each project is a safety case. It contains the argumentation for the product being safe. The next point, number five, is about building trust. Function safety also means preventing a project from misinterpreting ISO 26262 and cheating. This is to be ensured through confirmation measures carried out by independent parties. There are three types of confirmation measures. Confirmation reviews related to key work products like the safety plan or safety concepts. They need confirmation from an independent person. For a functional safety audit, it has to be checked whether the project actually implements the necessary and defined procedures. The audit therefore relates to compliance with the processes. For a release for production, it's necessary to get an evaluation from an independent person of achieved safety. This is called a functional safety assessment. It's necessary for products requiring high integrity, like, for example, adaptive cruise control. Last but not least, a development result may only be released for production if there is a safety case, if functional safety is confirmed independently, and if the development result is baselined under configuration control. Why? I'd like to formulate it as key lesson number five. Independent confirmation measures should prevent development from misinterpreting ISO 26262 and cheating. The last point relates to the phase after you have finished development. If your development result was made safe using such safety management procedures, you must then ensure that the product is also produced correctly and remains safe over the lifetime of the vehicles. ISO 26262 requires that the companies involved name the people who are responsible for production and field monitoring, and that the necessary activities for functional safety are planned and initiated. Appropriate procedures must also be in place for this. These are, for example, certain control steps in production, such as reading out flashed software to ensure that there are no bit errors on the control units. The field observation process must ensure that field returns are examined for violations of safety goals. Finally, functional safety requires that software or hardware in the vehicles be replaced if necessary using a formalized change process. This is the last key point, number 6. To safeguard functional safety, not just during development and vehicle production, but also over the whole vehicle lifetime, suitable planning is necessary, including a field monitoring process and change management. Okay, this was an overview of the management of automotive functional safety according to ISO 26262. What lessons have we learned? Here is my summary of what you should remember. First, managing functional safety needs to be addressed on an organizational level, on a per project level, and for the time after release for production. Second, your development organization must have a culture and processes that support functional safety. Third, each safety-related electronics project has a safety manager responsible for this area and tailored safety planning. When we go through the other parts of ISO 26262, you will find that there are many topics that go beyond usual project management and require specific know-how on functional safety. Fourth, a key result of each project is a safety case containing the argumentation for the product being safe. Lesson learned number 5. Three kinds of independent confirmation measures should prevent development teams from misinterpreting ISO 26262 and cheating. Confirmation reviews of key work products, like for example the safety concept and safety case. At least one functional safety process audit, ensuring that you follow the necessary process steps. And a functional safety assessment to judge and confirm the achievement of functional safety by an independent person. And the last point, to ensure functional safety is met during component and vehicle production, as well as over the whole vehicle lifetime, suitable planning is necessary. This includes a field monitoring process that detects violations of safety goals and change management. So, there were a lot of different aspects that I could only briefly address in this video. You're probably wondering how to address these topics in practice. For this, we have made a whole series of free expert videos. For example, on how to embed functional safety in an existing development process, or on the role of the safety manager. If you need to prepare for an external assessment, our video on functional safety assessment can be useful. Watch the corresponding video. Subscribe our channel not to miss the next videos. I hope you enjoyed this one and recommend it to your colleagues.